a lot of times if people have weak hands or they feel stressed, they are given this idea from maybe friends that they should be squeezing these little squishy balls. But is that really such a good idea? Is that really such a good idea for someone who may have an overuse injury? Here to answer this question is Dr. Robert Markison, our medical expert.
Click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you'll know when new videos are posted.
So Dr. Markison, what do you think of these squeezy balls?
Well, the problem with it is you have 9 tendons, 1 for thumb, 2 per digit, traveling back and forth through this tunnel in company with the nerve. The more you squeeze, the more you grip, the greater the chance of irritating the nerve by tightening up those tendons that are living right near the nerve. And these 2 central digits in particular, if you look at the cross-sectional anatomy of the carpal tunnel, these 2 guys are presenting very forward, very palmar, very towards the nerve. Because they're right under the nerve. So gripping these can compress or displace the nerve to one side or another, usually towards the thumb. The other topographic anatomy is that the index and little finger tendons are behind those. So if you really look at this configuration, you've got middle and ring, and then you've got index and little, and then you've got nerve right here. And so you're pushing up against the nerve, and it may slide over towards the thumb side. And so sustained gripping is probably not a good idea, but anatomy's destiny vis-a-vis, do you have prolongation of muscle bellies that are tightening up in addition to tendons? Do you have muscles from the far side called lumbricals that are packing it when you grip? And so these are issues of, one, what your anatomy is and what it will tolerate, and pushing up against the undersurface backside of a nerve, which is then in turn pushing up against the undersurface of the roof of the carpal tunnel, aka transverse carpal ligament or flexor retinaculum. And that's an unyielding, thick, like gristle, thick tunnel, thick roof.
You know, I actually have one of these, and I also have repetitive strain injury. I find it very, it's like you're overusing all of those tendons all over again. So I find it irritating. In addition to what you're talking about, I find that it actually can flare me a little bit. So I would never use one of these myself.
Right. You don't need to. I mean, you have to think about what you need to do, work and play wise.
The other question that came up with this is, what about the thumb? Do you think that's a good idea for the thumb? You know, what if you've got arthritis or something?
Well, again, you have to think about load amplification or force coupling, wherein one ounce of pinch is 10 to 12 ounces at that vulnerable basal joint, also known as trapezio metacarpal or carpo metacarpal joint. So if I put 10 pounds there, I've got 100 to 120 pounds registering at that joint. And so it doesn't mean live a life without pinching and pinch gripping, but ease off. Never do any unnecessary stuff with the thumb, which in disability evaluations, which I must do every week, is 40% of the value of the hand.
Wow. Yes, I think sometimes, unfortunately, people have to learn that the hard way, but it's not an easy road back if you can even get back. Thank you so much for enlightening us about the rubber ball issue, Dr. Markison.
Sure.